In 2015, Uganda Supreme Court ruled against the practice of refunding bride price on the dissolution of a customary marriage, dubbing it unconstitutional. The judges noted that the practice suggested that women were in a marketplace and infringed on their right to divorce. As Uganda joins the world to mark the 16 days of activism campaign against violence on women and girls, the Minister of State for Gender, Peace Mutuzo, has expressed a need for a total ban of bride price in Uganda as a measure to mitigate gender-based violence.
My view, bride price should be out of our way completely. That cultural practice is archaic. It is one of the ways in which people are selling off others. We used to condemn slave trade, but now this is another slave trade. You are selling off your own daughter, your own blood, unknowingly.
Mutuzo says parents have commercialized bride price as a profitable venture to fetch them wealth at the cost of rights of their young girls, hence worsening the child marriage phenomena.
It's a total sale, a big transaction, commercial transaction. And we think if we remove the bride price, to begin with, how can you attach a price to a bride? That means it is a commercial commodity. A human being is not bought and therefore should not be sold. And it has also discouraged many young people who should have been freer in love from moving forward to legitimate their relationships.
The gender minister noted that many women have become victims of circumstances and have decided to stay in abusive marriages because they don't have money to pay back the bride price. She called upon culture chiefs to review this custom for the better being of the girl child.
On occasions now, we see people paying dowry in form of cars. A car from Japan, how did it become part of our customs and traditions? Fourth, it is removing or denying the potential of girls to be actualized in terms of education, in terms of growth, the brain to grow, to be able to mature up.
Mutuzo, who represents Bunyangabu District as a woman MP, wants the public to join government to enforce the 2015 Supreme Court ruling against bride price in order to create a peaceful environment for women and girls.
Pronouncements are parts of our laws, and it only requires enforcement. Because by the time court processes such a pronouncement, it means it has been able to investigate deeply and has realized that this is a menace and it is not lawful, and they realize it is wrong. So it is our responsibility, me and you, and duty bearers. Talk about teachers, talk about parents, talk about religious institutions, talk about traditional and cultural institutions. All these have been playing a hand in enforcing some of these cultural practices.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.